Next on Eyewitness News at 6, for the first time in nearly a year and a half, a cruise ship is leaving Southern California with passengers. We have the latest on how the cruise industry is navigating its return amid a rising number of COVID cases.
Plus, local demonstrators show support for the women and children of Afghanistan, now under Taliban rule as the U.S. looks to get more evacuees out of the country.
And stunning new video from the Calder fire shows just how quickly homes can be surrounded.
Those stories plus Alex Cheney tracking the warm up in our AccuWeather forecast. Eyewitness News at 6.
What's at stake in the September 14th recall? It's a matter of life and death. With Delta surging, Gavin Newsom is protecting California, requiring vaccination for health workers and school employees. The top Republican candidate, he peddled deadly conspiracy theories and would eliminate vaccine mandates on day one, threatening school closures and our recovery. Stop the spread. Return your ballot or vote in person by September 14th. Protect California by voting no on the Republican recall.
Live from ABC 7, this is Eyewitness News.
Cruise industry is back in Southern California as this excited passenger runs to board the first cruise ship to leave in some 17 months. The latest sign of a surge in summer travel despite a surge in COVID cases. Hello, thanks for joining us. I'm Jory Rand.
I'm Veronica Miracle, and this is Eyewitness News at 6 on ABC 7, Hulu Live, and wherever you stream. Cruise lines, a big part of Southern California's thriving tourism industry. And after a shutdown since the start of the pandemic, it is finally coming back.
Eyewitness News reporter Amy Powell is live in Long Beach this evening, where a ship has finally headed out to open seas. Amy.
Jory and Veronica, the Carnival Panorama departed about a half hour ago, a long-awaited journey for thousands of travelers and the many people who work in the industry.